गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे टू स्टार्ट विद बिजनेस सेशन, बिजनेस स्टडी सेशन, नेचर एंड पर्पस ऑफ बिजनेस, विल डिस्कस ऑक्सिलरीज ऑफ ट्रेड. नाउ ऑक्सिलरीज ऑफ ट्रेड रेफर टू दोज एक्टिविटीज विच आर अंडरटेकन टू ओवरकम द हर्डल्स अपेयरिंग इन द वे ऑफ ट्रेड, ओवरकम द हर्डल्स और बॉटलनेक विद द प्रॉब्लम्स विच आर फेस्ड. नाउ देयर आर सिक्स प्रॉब्लम्स विच आर फेस्ड. First, the hindrance of person is removed by middleman. Hindrance of place is removed by transport and communication. Hindrance of time is removed by warehousing. Hindrance of risk is removed by insurance. Hindrance of finance is removed by banking. Hindrance of information removed by advertising. Now, first we'll do hindrance of persons, which is removed by middleman. Now, a middleman, like goods are produced at a particular place, but they are consumed throughout the world or throughout the country. So it's not possible for a producer to meet each and every customer to sell his product. Let's take an example of your shampoo or soap. They are produced somewhere else, but they are consumed throughout the India or throughout the world. So it's not possible for a producer to have a direct contact with the consumer. So there is a need for a person to who can remove this hindrance. So this can be, first of all, he will sell it to wholesaler. Wholesaler is a person who buy goods in large quantity from the producer. Then wholesaler will sell it to retailer. Retailer is a person who buy goods in smaller quantity from wholesaler, and the retailer will ultimately sell in much smaller quantity to the consumer as and when required. Now, second is your transport and communication. Now, goods are produced at one particular place, but they are consumed at certain other place. So, it's not possible for a producer to sell the product to the consumer directly. So, there is a strong need for transport and communication. So, for transport and communication is required. If transport is good, the car transport acts as an artery in your body, like the blood is carried away by veins and arteries. Same way, transport helps a producer to sell its product to different, to send its product to the different areas. Now, hence there is one hindrance in trade which is removed by transporting of goods from place of production to the place of consumption. The other aspect of hindrance of place is that producer and purchaser are scattered. The problem which arises as to how to finalize the deal of sales and purchases. This problem can be solved by communication. Now there are various ways, either telephonically or through net, you can have communication. Now next is warehousing. There is a gap between the manufacturing of a product and consumption of that product, because some goods they are manufactured throughout the year, but they are consumed during a particular season. Like take an example of cotton clothes or woolen clothes. Now cotton clothes they are produced throughout the year, but they are consumed only in summer season. Or other vice versa, woolen clothes are produced throughout the year, but they are consumed only during winter season. Same goes for your water coolers also. So there is a need for to keep them safely, so warehousing is required. Next is your insurance. Insurance means transferring of your risk, because there is a risk, whether it's a small business or a large business, there is a risk. While transportation, while storage, a risk is there. So to remove that risk, element of risk, insurance is required. Now insurance company, they take a particular some amount which is known as premium, and they cover the risk. Now next comes the banking. Finance is the backbone of business, because it is required from the moment the raw material is purchased till the sale of finished product. So a businessman is always in a shortage of funds. How much he can invest from his funds? So which he compensated by borrowing from outside, and this hurdle is removed through banking. If a strong banking system is there in any country, that's good for the business bank. Now next is your advertising. Today there is a cutthroat competition. Like take an example of any FMCG product. A large N number of sellers are there. And consumers are confused which product they have to buy. So too, it is not possible for a businessman to sit and wait for consumer after investing heavily in the business. To attract consumer towards his products, a producer has to provide full knowledge to his products to the consumer, and to overcome this problem, advertisement is required. Advertisement enhances the knowledge of customer and eliminates the hindrance of information. Now, advertisement is a monologue. It can be in the print media, it can be in web, it can be through your TV, in cinema halls. So there are different ways of advertisement. Thank you.